Now, the News 8 Storm Team forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Just like that, the clouds are starting to roll back in, as we see in our live Harrisburg Skycam. Most of the Susquehanna Valley had some decent sunshine this afternoon, but now we're starting to fade behind the cloud cover, and that's going to bring us our next round of wet weather. Some more rain on the way. Not this evening, though, just increasing cloud cover. It'll stay mild. The clouds will act kind of like a blanket. It's not literally how it works, but it does keep temperatures from dropping off too much. We'll be in the 60s and upper 50s for most of this evening. Then late tonight, under overcast skies, that's when some of the light rain and drizzle will be arriving. In some spots in time for the morning rush hour, lows will be 50 to 54. And temperatures will stay there for most of the morning as the rain continues. Then in the afternoon, we'll get a push of some milder air all over again on some stronger southeasterly winds. It's going to become windy in the afternoon, too, as the rain and drizzle continue. Highs will be 62 to 68. Then we stay there for most of tomorrow night. And we start to pull in some cooler air as we head towards Thursday. In the meantime, nice temperatures out there, 70 degrees in Carlisle, 66 in Lewistown, a lot of spots in the upper 60s right now, 68 degrees in York, Lancaster also at 68 degrees, Oxford's coming in at 67, 69 in Lebanon, so pretty decent temperatures for this time of the year, this time of day. Even though a lot of us have gone overcast already, not picking up any rain yet on super Doppler 8, but a good 10 to 20 good 10 to 12 hours from now, we'll start to see some bands of rain coming up from the south. Right now, we've got 67 degrees at Harrisburg International Airport. We do have some dry air that this rain has to overcome first, so that'll cause some evaporation. That'll cool the atmosphere down later on. The relative humidity is only 44%. Light winds out of the southeast at 3 miles per hour. So it's a very large storm system, the latest in all the storm systems we've had this year. The center of the first wave of low pressure now moving into parts of the Ohio Valley, and the area of low pressure that was forming off the coast of Florida now starting to move up to the north. And as this warm front moves through during the day tomorrow, that's when we start to get that spike in temperatures in the afternoon. So it's really kind of two different areas of low pressure affecting us, all bringing us this rainfall. The clouds continue to increase on the regional satellite and the radar. This first band will continue to move up towards the Great Lakes. We're actually going to get the rain from the southern low moving up the coast first later on tonight. And we'll put our predictor computer model into motion here and show you the timetable. The clouds continue to thicken tonight, and then we get some of that light rain and drizzle early tomorrow morning. It looks like the heaviest of the rain may stay just to our east, for the first low, but we're still going to have umbrella weather here, some light to sometimes moderate rain, and it all kind of just wraps around into the center of the storm system, which will be over the Ohio Valley and western PA Wednesday night through Thursday. So we still have some lingering showers. Notice the change in the wind arrows to more of a westerly direction Thursday night and Friday. That's going to start to pull in some cooler air as we dry it out. It'll start to feel a lot more fall-like by the time we get to the end of the work week. So again, in the mid-60s tomorrow, that'll be a late day high, probably in the afternoon. Rainy and windy. The windy conditions will continue into Thursday. 60 will be the high for the day. That'll probably be in the morning, and it should get cooler as the day goes on. A breezy and cool day all day on Friday, highs around 56. Then the wind dies down as we head into the weekend. High pressure will build in, bring us more sunshine and more seasonable temperatures back into the lower 60s. So we could be looking at another inch of rain out of this. Some spots may get as much as two. Luckily, we have some room for that to go right now. We're not thinking about any flooding on any large scale out of this.
My thoughts exactly. At least we have somewhere for it to flow now. Yeah, all right, thank you, Matt.